Ah yes, the anticipation of searching for tickets to a sporting event, finding a good seat for the right price, forking out your hard-earned money, schlepping to the stadium, and then getting sat behind a rail for 3 hours. Well, today, I've done your homework for you. I went out and found the worst stadium seats money can buy. Hey, one less thing in life to be disappointed about, and they're all coming up right after this. They say these seats aren't for sale on game day, but if somehow the Trojans became relevant again, I'm sure they would sell these seats if they could. The view is obstructed by the press box and club seating level, which was added in 2019. Over half the field is obstructed by income disparity. Okay, I couldn't find the exact location of this seat. However, if you go to the home of the Blackpool Football Club, avoid the visitor side in the front row. There, 9 poles block the views from the stands, and one is so bad not even the chair can fold down. Allegedly, the seat costs 25 quid. At first glance, this doesn't look so bad. You have a nice full-length view of the ice, and this is in a bar area where you will be served food and drink. Only problem, the frozen sheet is much longer than a basketball court, so if you come to see the stars, you won't be able to see 1/3 of the ice. Either that or you will lean over the ledge and spill either beer or yourself onto the people below. The old Meadowlands had plenty of obstructed view seats, mostly from Jets fans standing up and talking shit about Ken O'Brien. The new digs have both that, and some seats that are blocked by poles. The poles bear the weight of the upper deck, and partially or fully obstruct the views of the field. Imagine sitting through this and going home to your $4,000 a month apartment after either the Jets or the Giants lose. This seat is Spano's fault. For 3 years, the Chargers played in Dignity Health Sports Park in front of empty seats and opposing fans. Views like this didn't help, as a rail and chain-link fence obstruct the field. Though, I doubt any Chargers fans bought these seats. Hell, I doubt any fan bought these seats. These are now the problem of the LA Galaxy. More visitor section hate. Here at the home of Queens Park Rangers, we have set up a nice visiting section. However, we needed to suspend what looked like media/press areas in each corner of the venue, making these seats worthless. Well, at least you get to see some guy execute a corner kick. Okay, this is unfair because even though these seats sucked, the Yankees got a lot of flack for them, and they actually deleted the obstructive view seats in center field. They simply removed large sections of the outfield bleachers. So you can save your money and not pay for a bad seat, just underperforming baseball. Okay, first of all, this is a pretty ugly, asymmetrical stadium to begin with. I guess you'll never walk alone here at Anfield, mostly because you'll need a seeing eye dog to be able to see the pitch. Yes, the Anfield Road stands were built in 1998 and have a roof that obstructs almost the entire field. This is the stadium that canceled an NFL game because of a Shakira concert. But apparently the playing surface isn't the only thing not worthy of writing home about. Here is your end zone view of the football field, complete with barbed wire and chicken wire. Maybe they are actually raising chickens in the upper deck, and this makes sense. A pretty stadium from the outside, not looking so hot from the inside. This stadium is beautiful, completely circular, with a cool roofing system. Unfortunately for those seated next to the press box, well, you don't get to see much of the stadium at all, or the field. Maybe this is where they send political prisoners to live out the rest of their days, wondering if that goal went in or not. And finally, the granddaddies of obstructed view seating. Now look, old school engineers didn't have access to high-grade steel and concrete, so they did what they could. which was the use of poles in these over 100-year-old ballparks. Wrigley kind of has an excuse, as the poles are holding up the grandstand and roof, but there are areas in the outfield of Fenway that really have no excuse. Two pieces of advice: never buy tickets from a scalper, and if you ever go to Wrigley or Fenway, make sure you check your view from the seats. Enjoy the slideshow. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. Please not forget to like, comment, and subscribe for more interesting films on all sports. I'm 5 Points Vids, and you made it to my next video.